Good afternoon, everybody. This is Doc Stout coming back to play more of the Invader Zim series on Dark Souls. We have a new set of settings to make sure that my crash bugs that have been happening intermittently and ending some videos and losing some footage here and there shouldn't happen anymore. So if something looks weird with the video, it might be due to my new broadcast settings. Please leave comments here or on YouTube whether you like it, whether you'd like me to just reduce the quality and go back to the old way. Let's get in game and see what we've got going on, though. Because the last time I played Zim, some rather difficult things happened. I managed to get all the way to the Bell Gargoyles, and I got this spiffy axe that I wasn't high enough level to use. So, in between this time and last time, I managed to work a little bit on grinding, killed a bunch of guys, got my strength up so I could use this axe that actually was from the gargoyle boss. You can see it's made of the gargoyle tail, and it looks so badass when you do the heavy attack with it. It actually bends like a gargoyle tail. We also made an enemy who I realize maybe I shouldn't have angered. Ooh. We've got some bells going off. I do have 4 soft humanity here, so maybe going straight to the Bell Gargoyles isn't the best plan, but considering that it is a Friday afternoon, and I'm just as likely to find someone who wants to kill me if I go human as I am likely to find someone willing to help me, I think I'm going to make my first attempt just like this, and risk losing the humanity. Here comes the mosh pit. This is a little bit easier with the axe as well. I just got to be careful not to run out of stamina or let them get any swings in, because their clubs are a little faster than the axe. If you're watching live and you see the stream suddenly go dark, that means that my settings test didn't work, and I'm having heating issues, which would be bad. Bad for business. I also, in the course of leveling up, got the Titanite to level up the Gargoyle Axe to a +5. So I should hit just a little harder. Whew! Wow, we're getting right into the action here. This hits decently hard. I just wish I could get more than one swing in with it. Okay, there's 2. So my phone is going crazy. I don't know if you can hear the Hadoukens in the background. Uh-oh, we got the second one. You gotta be real careful. Oh, they both hit me with fire. That's a great way to lose. Alright. See what's going on in chat real quick. Looks like the stream configuration quality is doing better than looks like the stream mild viz. Quality is doing better than looks like. Let's make sure that I'm not listening to myself though. Okay. Just a little bit of slowdown. Shouldn't be too much longer. When we can get our schedules worked out, I'm going to do streaming like this with my wife, moderating the chat. Days like today, where the chat is light, won't actually need much moderation, but I'll also have her live on mic. So, get a little bit of interaction there. I also plan to do a little bit of co-op, not in Dark Souls, but in some other games, with some of the guys from the podcast I'm involved with, 40 going on 14. if you discovered the Twitch or YouTube channel from the podcast, welcome. Alright, we're going to try this again. Man, I got four soft humanity just sitting there. I'm losing a couple frames here, but the other thing I like is that these guys are way easier with the Gargoyle Axe. The Balder Knights, I was having issues fighting with the short sword. It just didn't do enough damage. Now all I gotta wait for is a single opening and just start hacking away. Mosh Pit's a little easier to fight, too. Come on. Ouch. Though their clubs are still faster than my weapon. So if they get a lucky hit in, that's just bad for business. It'll also help if, in the Bell Gargoyle fight, I manage to use my Estus Flask, you know, once. Although my bonus Estus looks like I'm going to have to consume here. Bing! I'm not sure if that is someone else actually beating the Gargoyle bosses or what. I'm tempted to buff up, see what's going on. Although if I remember, buffing up didn't really help me all that much. Now, let's try it. Get the Estus Flask back on and go for broke. Oh, doesn't help if you miss. Let's grab my humanity back. Oh, the humanity. Ah, you're not gonna fool me. I knew you were gonna swing three times. Ouch! Woohoo! I'm gonna end up wasting. Yeah, I wasted the buff. Nope, it's still active. I can't get greedy. Well, I can, but I can't and expect to live. Oh! Aced the first one before the second one even got down. Oh, let's not screw this up now. Let's back off and flask up. Oh boy. Sweet. Oh, that was greedy. Okay, you breathe fire, I will drink. Okay. Uh-oh! If I'm not careful, it's gonna be good night for me. Yeah. I get the opportunity, I'm not gonna screw around, I'm just gonna drink. I think I'm going to double-hand it and try and finish him on my next opening. Which might be right here. Sweet. Victory. Awesome. Got two humanities for that. And we have progress on Invader Zim. Sweet. I will partially attribute my success to all of the grinding, and partially to being more confident that I will be able to do this video without my computer shutting down. So that's pretty sweet. If you're just tuning in, that's the reason why the video is a little bit letterboxed today. We're trying some new settings. I'm going to be fiddling over the next few weeks with my streams. All right. The Chosen Undead is supposed to ring the bell. Let's ring that bell. And I was planning on having to reach out for help to summon Solaire for this. Turns out, all I needed was to chop one of their tails off and beat them to death with it. It's actually the first time in three playthroughs that I've ever beaten the first gargoyle before the second one showed up. Pretty proud of that. Man, I got 11,000 souls. See, I'd be tempted to, like, screw around and do something else, but I think I just gotta get myself somewhere a little safer. Bank these souls, level up or something. Ah!
Greetings. I am Oswald of Kareem, the Pop.
No. I could buy forgiveness from Lautrec, but I don't think I want to. Huh. Whew. Cost all my souls? Nah, forget it. Let's learn a gesture from him. Well, what is it? Sweet. Alrighty. We're not going to join his covenant either, because we have a covenant in mind. The covenant is going to be the Dark Wraiths. Got a long way to go before we can join that, though. My apologies to the chat. I always have to alt-tab these days, which freezes the video for a couple seconds in order to interact with you. Alrighty. Yeah, if I didn't have so many souls, I would just use this and try to actually beat Lautrec. Well, I'm not even sure he's still here if you wait until after beating the gargoyles. There's another place he goes to after beating the gargoyles if you don't piss him off. It'd actually be really, really dangerous to my future in this playthrough if he moved to there and is just angry with me. Will be a learning experience for me. Another reason why I've got this axe at +5 is that it scales pretty well with dex, which, though I'm tempted to raise my vitality, dex-based weapons are a little bit more thief-like, so we might just pump the old dexterity just a little bit. I don't know. I definitely want to spend these souls before I start exploring, though. Well, let's split the difference. Let's do 1 and 2. 2 points of dex and 1 point of vitality. That'll make me hit a little bit harder and get a few more hit points. Alright, this is where... Okay, he's not over... Lautrec is not over here. I'm gonna go back up and see if we could fight him again. For some reason, I keep accidentally double-handing this. So glad to make progress on this series. I was almost afraid to record again because I didn't want another video of just trying and failing to beat the gargoyles. I even got to keep my four soft humanity. I may just be leaving it where Lautrec is, but at the very least, let's look to see if he's still there. Alright, chop you up a little bit. Ooh. Rapier. That's a good PvP weapon, I hear. For dex-based characters. I wonder if I one-shot these guys yet. Oh, yeah. I wasn't sure I was going to hit anybody with that, but it looks so cool. It's too slow. I gotta not screw around and just take these guys out one or two at a time. He's gonna rush me. Oh! For big dumb hollows, they're pretty smart. They have not complete lost faith yet. There's actually another area coming up. It's going to be a while, but where the hollows have completely lost all hope. They don't even attack you. So, of course, you kill them for souls. So that's what a hero does. Sweet, sweet souls. Hey, buddy. You here? Oh, he's here. He's not happy with me. You know, I try and stab him once. Oh, boy. He hurts. He hurts so bad. Oh, shit! One member of the mosh pit. Looks like I forgot about him. Okay! Ouch! 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 Try and drink again. Oh, no. Oh, he just parried me! That hurts. Ouch. Okay. This new weapon's pretty cool, but... Oh, boy. It'd be cool if I could get a backstab in. Man, I wish I'd seen that other guy. Okay. Now it's down to a one-on-one fight. I don't know if it's a fair fight, but... Just gotta be careful, because I think he can go around the shield. Oh, he just tried to parry me. Oh, boy! Oh, that should have been a backstab. Am I gonna get him? Oh! Not if I let him do that! And I'm not practiced enough with this particular shield to do that to him. I forgot to lock on. Ugh! So close, so far away. His ring is so good. Alright, well... Got a new challenge for the next episode. This series, I guess. I think I'm going to call it... I did accomplish something, so that's nice. But this seems like a pretty good spot to roll the credits and see what it all looks like. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in with my wonky little thanks for tuning in thing. Let's fix that. As always, I can be found here on Twitch at Doc Stout. All the archives are going to go to the YouTube channel, DocStout076 over at YouTube. I've got a Google Plus page now. Every Monday, new posting of the podcast at 40go14.com. Check it out. I will put some links in the YouTube video, but this looks like a nice short video. So we're going to call it here. Thanks to everybody for tuning in, and I will talk to everybody later.